Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Exercise 9.2, question number 5. Before starting this question, we will define a right triangle, a right angle triangle. Its definition is written on page 220 of your textbook. What is right angle triangle? A right angle triangle has one angle equal to 90 degree. That is right angle. Or whenever we have a right angle triangle ABC, then to prove that AB and C are the vertices of a right triangle, we have a theorem which is called Pythagoras theorem. What is Pythagoras theorem? First, check a triangle ABC, which is a right angle triangle. Here, side AC is called hypotenuse, side AB is called base, side AC is called perpendicular. Now, Pythagoras theorem is hypotenuse square equals to base square plus perpendicular square. Now, we will use this theorem in question number 5 to prove that the given points A, B and C are the vertices of a right triangle. Now, let us start its solution. Let the points A, minus 2, minus 2, B, 4, minus 2 and C, 4, 6 are the vertices of a right triangle. Then, A, B, BC and AC, you can see, are the lengths of the sides of triangle. Now, how to find these three lengths? Obviously, here we will use distance formula. Now, what is distance formula? Distance formula is square root x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. By using this distance formula, we will find out AB length, which is equals to, by using the coordinate of A point x1, y1 and the coordinate of point B x2, y2. Putting in distance formula, we will get 4 minus minus 2 whole square plus minus 2 minus minus 2 whole square. First becomes 4 plus 2 whole square and second becomes minus 2 plus 2 whole square, and which is equals to 6 square plus 0 over square root gives 6. Now we have to prove that the given points are the vertices of a right triangle. So we need lengths in square. So taking square on both sides, AB length 6, AB square length 36. Now find next length, BC. By using again distance formula x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Here we will take x1, y1 the value of B and x2, y2 the value of C coordinate. Now, after putting values, we have 4 minus 4 whole square plus 6 minus minus 2 whole square, which becomes 6 plus 6 plus 0 plus 6 plus 2 whole square gives 8 square root. And finally, we have BC length 8. Again, we need square. So, squaring on both sides, length of BC square gives 64. Similarly, we will find out the length AC again by using distance formula x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square over square root. And by putting the value of x1, y1 for point A and x2, y2 for point C, we will get 4 minus minus 2 whole square plus 6 minus minus 2 whole square over square root, which will becomes 4 plus 2 square plus 6 plus 2 square over square root, and which gives AC length equals to 6 square root of 6 square plus 8 square gives 36 plus 64 square root, which is square root of 100, which is equals to 10. And again, we have to take square. So, square of the length AC gives 100. Now, you can see, students, the value of AC square is 100. The value of AB square is 36. The value of BC square is 64. Which implies AB square plus BC square is equals to AC square. That is 36. Putting values, 36 plus 64 gives 100. 100 equals to 100. It implies that it satisfies Pythagoras theorem. Thus, the given points A, B and C are the vertices of a right triangle.